What should I do about Bryant air conditioner problems?
Almost anything that goes wrong is traced to the coils and the compressor,
both of which are expensive to replace.
You can clean the coils to see if that improves its efficiency, and cleaning the outside of the condenser gives you an idea as to where the leaks are.
Unless it is the valves or joints.
That's true. You can try adding no-weld adhesive to the joints to reduce leaks there, especially if you see bubbling there when you are cleaning the thing.
Or replace the valves.
Bryant is not known for bad valves, just bad everything else, though if it is the valve, it is probably the thermal coupling valve.
Such as?
The evaporator coils dying in only a few years. Leak, a lot, and the drains do not handle it well. So you end up with puddles around the unit to rust it out and high moisture inside the unit to get mold.
I could try cleaning out the drain tube in case that gets clogged and cleaning the inside of the AC unit with bleach water, but I do not even like to replace the air filter.
If you have a Bryant, you need to replace the filter if only to avoid humid air recirculating around the thing and lowered efficiency.
That's standard for all ACs.
The coils tend to leak, even if it has not rusted through. And their warranty does not cover refrigerant recharging.
None of them do.
Even if the part is under warranty, you have to pay for refrigerant, diagnostics and labor. So even when the coil is under warranty, it is $1,000.
So without the warranty, it is more like $2,000.
And the condensers leak, usually needing to be replaced every 2 or 3 years. Their condensers have issues, but you can add an HVAC hard start kit to help keep it going until it is really, really dead.
I know what a zombie AC is. It whines, groans, moans but does not do anything else.
Their motors tend to die every few years.
That's standard for all HVAC equipment. Can I fix the motor by switching out the motor capacitor?
Maybe, but good luck getting that information from Bryant. Their solution is sending a repair tech instead.
It is $100 or $200 just to have the guy to come out, much less replace a $10 part.
It is still cheaper than installing a train, though after a few years, replacing it with another Bryant would have been cheaper than fixing it.